Modern parallel machines offer a lot of challenges in converting the algorithms and the techniques that we have learned so far into scalable implementations. Now, what are some of these challenges? Well, first of all, there's a size bloat of the operating system. And the size bloat comes because of additional features that we have to add to the operating system and so on. And that results in system software bottlenecks, especially for global data structures. And then, of course, we already have been discussing this quite a bit, that the memory latency to go from the processor to memory is huge. All the cores of the processor are on a chip, and if you go outside the chip to the memory, that latency is huge. 100-to-1 ratio is what we've been talking about, and that latency is only growing. The other thing that happens in parallel machines is the fact that this is a single node, and we're talking about the memory latency going from the processor to a memory, but in a parallel machine, it's typically constructed as a non-uniform memory access machine. And that is, you take individual nodes like this that contains a processor and memory and put all of them together and connect them through an interconnection network. And what happens with this NUMA architecture is that access, there is differential access to memory, whether this processor is accessing memory that is local to it, or it has to reach out into the network and access some memory that is farther away from where it is. In addition to the NUMA effect, there is also the memory hierarchy itself is very deep. We already talked about the fact that a single processor these days contains multiple levels of caches before it goes to the memory. And this deep memory hierarchy is another thing that you have to worry about in building the operating system for a parallel machine. And there is the issue of fault sharing. And fault sharing is essentially saying that even though programmatically there is no connection between a piece of memory that is being touched by a particular thread executing on this core, another thread that is executing on this core, the cache hierarchy may make the block that contains the individual memory touched by different threads on different cores to be on the same cache block. So programmatically, there's no sharing, but because of the fact that the memory that is being touched by a thread on this core and the memory that is being touched by a thread on this core happen to be on the same cache line, they appear to be shared. That's what is fault sharing. Fault sharing is essentially saying that there is no programmatic sharing, but because of the way the cache coherence mechanism operates, they appear shared. And this is happening more and more in modern processes because modern processes tend to employ larger cache blocks. Why is that? Well, the analogy I'm going to give you is that of a handyman. If you're good at doing chores around the house, then you might relate to this analogy quite well. You probably have a toolbox if you're a handyman. And if you want to do some work, let's say a leaky faucet that you want to fix, what you do is you put the tools that you need into a tool tray and bring it from the toolbox to the site where you're doing the work. And basically what you're doing there is, you know, collecting the set of tools that you need for the project so that you don't have to go running back to the tool tray all the time. That's the same sort of thing that's happening with caching and memory. Memory contains all this stuff, but what I need, I want to bring it in. And the more I bring in from the memory, the less time that I have to go out to memory in order to fetch it. That means that I want to keep increasing the block size of the cache in order to make sure that I take advantage of spatial locality in the cache design. And that increases the chances that fault sharing is going to happen. The larger the cache line, the more chances are that memory that is being touched by different threads happen to be on the same cache block, and that results in fault sharing. So all of these effects, the NUMA effect, the deep memory hierarchy, and increasing block size leading to fault sharing, all of these are things that the operating system designer has to worry about in making sure that the algorithms and the techniques that we have learned, when it is translated to a large-scale parallel machine, it remains scalable. So that's really the challenge that the operating system designer faces. So some of the things that the OS designer would have to do is work hard to avoid fault sharing, work hard to reduce write sharing the same cache line, because if you write share the same cache line, then it is going to result among different cores of the same processor, then it is going to result in that cache line migrating from one processor to another. And even within the same core, and even within the same processor, multiple cores, and across processors that are on different nodes of parallel machine connected by the interconnection network.